Hi everyone, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Mrs. R. Cynthia, Assistant Professor, Department of Food Processing and Preservation Technology, Faculty of Engineering, Avinashlingam University, Coimbatore. Today, we are going to discuss about the topic packaging strategy. First, introduction. The shortage in the values of packaging in the country has become conscious only in the background of expert advertising, where it happens to be one of the main uncertain blocks. But not much can be done about it as long as the export of products in consumer packages continues to be a small fraction of the total exports. But to achieve this, the country has to take a quantum jump in package distribution of foods within the country. After going through this session, you will be able to understand the importance of packaging, packaging design, factors affecting packaging strategy. First, importance of packaging to marketing. Packaging is a very vital marketing strategy to glamorize your product in order to create a center of consumers' attention. Sometimes packaging is so essential that it costs more than the product itself in order to attract the consumers to buy it. The right packaging can help a brand fashion a unique position in the marketplace and in the minds of consumers. Packaging has a better contact than promotion does and can set a brand apart from its competitors. It upholds and emphasizes the purchase resolution not only at the summit of the purchase but also every time the product is used. Packaging has a better reach than advertising does and can set a brand apart from its competitors. It encourages and strengthens the purchase resolution not only at the point of purchase but also every time the product is used. Packaging in diverse portion can make bigger a product into new broad markets or help to rise above cost barriers. Packaging can even force the brand choice. It was set up out the most clients that like the product's quality after they purchase the required packaged product. Based on those evidence, we cannot say there is 100% equal affiliation between good package and good product quality, but there is a constructive thoughts and movement about well-designed package shows high product quality. As a matter of fact, people are becoming more and more challenging. Packaging has become increasingly shown as imperative role in a way to serving consumers by given that information and delivering functions. Packaging in different serving sizes can extend a product into new target markets or help to overcome cost barriers. Packaging can even drive the brand choice, especially in the context of children product. As the market becomes more competitive and shelf space is at a premium, products need to be able to stand out from the crowd, and packaging needs to provide more than just functional benefits and information. With its diverse functionality to relieve and to be in touch with consumers, there is no doubt about the role of packaging as a deliberate tool to be focused for consumers' attention and their sensitivity on the quality of product. Having eye-catching packaging doesn't mean you should neglect excellent either. In fact, you need to make high-quality products in order to have a repeated sales. Converting first-time buyers into a loyal customers should be the main goal of your business, and packaging is the door to it. Next is packaging design. The goal of packaging design is to create a center of attention to consumers' attention. For this reason, packaging designs cannot immediately inform the customers but also incite feelings and communication emotions. An effective packaging seems to be attractive, make an impact on originality, and is just satisfying to have on the shelf. Logos, fonts, description and colors are some of the important outfits that are used in packaging design. Companies support their brands by creating a specific look and feel to their product's packaging. A customer must feel secure enough with the presentation of the company's brand to want to purchase the product. The inconvenience of packaging in the country are reasonably difficult, but these problems are solvable provided there is a need and eagerness to meet the situation directly and by taking the corrective action. Some of the major problem areas associated with the packaging are discussed below. First one is logistics. These main goods have to be moved through 623,000 km of exterior roads and 60,900 km of government railways out of the country trade will have to be moved through sea and air. The tonnages moved crossway the country are vast. The below table shows the tonnages moved across the country by different modes of transport. The country covers 5,76,000 villages in addition to 3,300 towns. The number of shop outlets to be checked becomes reasonably understandable. Self-service stores are unidentified and goods are traded across the country. Next one is handling. The ease of use of manual labor together with the problem of being without a job provides for comparatively cheap labor and therefore manual handling rules the prospect. Next one is transportation. The association of goods from villages to towns where the markets are uses the bullock carts, subsequently trucks and rail wagons take over. Two major systems of railway exist, one with the broad gauge and other with the meter gauge. To some extent, narrow gauge also continues. Economic process of transport system insists numerous number of transshipments involving handling and storage. Lack of sufficient storage amenities has added to the problem. The next one is infrastructure development. The critical areas listed above are not peculiar only to India. Countries like US have overcome the challenges posed by distances, warehousing, handling, etc. by bringing in and building up the necessary infrastructure so that losses down the line during distribution are minimized, if not totally prevented. As long as these infrastructure facilities are looked upon as investment instead of expenditure, it is possible to solve the problems posted. But till then, the country continues to suffer due to the lack of organized measures at developing the subject of physical distribution within the country. The next one is low per capita packaging consumption. Most of the major packaging materials are produced within the country, and by and large, the consumption needs are taken care of by domestic production barrier. Few exceptions like food grade tin plate and certain primary plastic raw materials like PVDC, which are imported based on current requirements. Though quantitatively the domestic production of packaging material is high, the per capita consumption is only 2% of an advanced state as the US. This is indicative also the potential for the growth. The next one is small scale sector in packaging. While the primary packaging materials like paper, plastics, etc. are all produced for large enterprises and even transnational operations in the country, the conversion industry is quite weak for historical reasons. Materials like polyethylene films, corrugated boxes, paper board, cartons are all reserved by the government for development in this segment of the industry, and these small units use the technologies of production obtaining at least about 2 decades or more ago in the developed world. As a result of such a reservation of this industry for small scale, we have about 9,500 small industries operating in the country which convert packaging material into packaging forms. Next one is large units. There are few hundred large enterprises also which are involved in similar products or slightly improved versions which are governed under the Industrial Development and Regulation Act of the government. So some of them have links with international giants like Continental Can, American Can, etc. The next one is packaging industry and its constraints. The quantity of large manufacturers are a small number, but the little ones are many. The total number though go beyond 250. In the face of large number of small scale packaging material converters and good many organizing units, it would appear that the situation with regard to packaging should be quite interesting. But the fact remains that in most sectors of packaging industry, there is a fair amount of surplus capacity. Sometimes the capacity utilization can be as low as 18% in some sectors of the industry. And especially when it happens in the small scale sector, the status of the sector becomes quite easy to understand. It becomes highly vulnerable, leading to a lot of quality deterioration and malpractices. The significant issues for such a poor state of affairs are: packaging should provide for the minimum additional cost. Packaging material should be available at economic prices. Packaging process must again add to the least cost. India happens to be among the few countries in the world where packaging costs are higher. Next one is taxation. Modern packaging material, such as in the field of plastic, attract the highest element of government levies. Some of the plastics intended for food packaging and which are not produced indigenously attract an import duty of the order of 24%. On some of the packaging materials that are produced locally but in insufficient quantity, the import duties amount to 156%. All the conventional packaging materials available within the country are imported, carry a high amount of central excise duty, and that too at multiple stages. The next one is government policy. A very large number of packaging items have been reserved for the development in the small scale sector. Most of these technologies are based on machinery and equipment that were adopted sometime in the early 60s in the developed world. They in turn belong perhaps to the technology of the 50s. Packaging is dynamic and changes are the rule. And in that kind of situation, these technologies have remained static within the country for a number of years, leading to inadequate quality levels or design stagnation, and therefore result in high cost. No organized and dispassionate review has been taken either to reserve or to deserve some of the sectors purely based on techno-economic feasibility or viability. Thus, naturally, there is no guarantee that the country has access to materials that are economically produced. The total lack of standardization and variety reduction has added to the incidence of higher cost. The next topic is technology upgradation. The majority of the packaging industries are in the small scale sector and cannot have enough money to start their own research and development. Those that are in structured sector are not capable to utilize the ability fully and create additional which can be provided in research and development. In this state, the technology has idled to the loss of economic growth. No effort have been made to provide the infrastructure for technology upgradation on the scale required to meet the needs by setting up package testing and development laboratories in distant part of the country where there is packaging industry attentiveness. As a result, no matter what quality is possible, as it is understood, is produced and used with the same extent of ignorance. Many times the packages fall short and the goods cannot even reach the target, let alone promote utilization. The next is weakness of food industry. It may be argued that it should be possible for the packaging industry to upgrade itself as long as a user can be educated and motivated. The picture of the food industry itself is not quite reassuring. The share of the food and beverage industry to the total industrial production is less than 10%, while the agriculture production alone contributes to about 40%. As against the 55 million tons in the domestic production of fruit and vegetables, the industrial capacity for converting these into processed foods is a mere 0.25% at 134,000 tons annually. It is a common knowledge that it is by and large food packaging that has contributed to the phenomenal growth of the packaging industry in the rest of the world. When the food industry does not grow, the packaging industry follows suit. Another uncomfortable feature of this situation is that when foods have to be marketed in consumer packages, they tend to attract a very high level of imports, sending them beyond the reach of the common man, whose interest and welfare the packaged products are supposed to protect. Next topic is law to protect consumers. Another strange phenomenon, perhaps peculiar to India, is that there is no law that demands that goods should be quality and quantity guaranteed for delivery to the ultimate consumer. Mostly, this is achievable through the medium of packaging. However, there are some regulations dealing with packaged commodities which prescribe how and in which form the packaging should be adopted. As a result of this law, there is a tendency to go away from packaging and avoid the legal problems and obligations, further limiting the opportunities for the growth of distribution of packaged products and of the packaging industry as a result. The next topic is public distribution. In a situation where one may not prefer to uphold branded sharing of essential goods and yet with a view to contribution a low-cost product to the poor, we have chosen to accept a public delivery system. But here again, packaging which can help reduce losses and damages down the line is not taken advantage for, it's considered to be an addition to the cost and not part of the product. The country therefore suffers not only the losses in distribution, but also more significantly the cost to the consumers in terms of short weights. Shocking estimates have been made of loss to the consumer through short weights. This is easy to understand. For a mere 5% short weight in commodities distributed would mean a loss of about 10 million tons of essential goods such as food grains, pulses, oils and sugar. The next topic is value-added exports. There is rightly a feeling that instead of exporting commodities in bulk, India should switch over to consumer packaged exports. Adequate incentives are offered to the export trade to achieve these objectives. The potential is obvious if we take a look at the export of commodities. If one were to imagine that all these quantities may have to be packaged in consumer units, the size of the market and needs become evident. If India exports of spices alone were to be packaged in consumer size packs for exports, the number of packages required would be in the region of 1.8 billion a year. While even a mere question of consumer packaging for exports alone should open up this potential, more than 50 times as much is the requirement of packaging for domestic distribution for value addition in the domestic markets itself. These developments are beginning to appear in the domestic market already. The next is cost-effective packaging. On the request that India is misfortune and that therefore consumers cannot afford packaged foods, it must be mentioned that industry and trade had not so far shown that vibrant to help the cause of consumer protection through better packaging. If this point of view were true, it is hard to understand the success achieved by large number of transnationals within the country who have popularized packaged foods. The next is trade. Having observed some of the dramatic successful introduction of packaged foods within the country, it is necessary that the trade has to evaluate their attitudes to their own business itself, let alone the involvement in the business of consumer protection. Modern packaging technologies, when properly applied, would guarantee to them a low-cost packaging system. They should learn from the dominant position of the brand leaders in the world to at most virtually dictate when the consumer should buy because of their supremacy and mastery over packaging, which deals with the subconscious level of the common consumers. Let us conclude as the present situation does create a feeling that it is difficult to revamp the status of food packaging in the country without undertaking any structural changes in all our policies and systems. Recent developments, however, have given some confidence that there is still some hope. Among the many measures that have been undertaken now are some that can lead to a program of development of the packaging industry in the long run.